Here's my finished card project. Now, what I've done along the side here is I've just taken a plain piece of ivory cardstock and I just scribbled some of that lighter blue marker just around the perimeter of the cardstock. And once I got a nice solid color all the way around, I took that same Copic blender pen and just colored little dots like that to create my border. So you can see I did that all around the perimeter of this layer of cardstock, and then I also did that all around the perimeter of this oval. And it makes such a nice border. It looks very soft and subtle, and then you can match your focal image perfectly with your pattern paper that's kind of going around the rim there. I used the little branch and the tweet thing phrase and the bird, all from the Falling for You Stamp TV kit. I also used the ivory cardstock from the Stamp TV kit and the black cardstock from the Stamp TV kit. Also, this ribbon came from Falling for You Stamp TV kit. So everything on this card, even though the color scheme in the kit is more warm tones for autumn, by using these markers and creating my own pattern paper, I created a really nice blue and white card rather than a warm tone card. Okay, now I want to show you one more fun thing that you can do with these. Let me grab another stamp here. I have the Trio of Trees, and I'm going to ink that up. Okay, and then I'm going to grab one of the brighter markers from this kit, this kind of hot orange here. It's almost a reddish orange, almost red, but definitely has an orange tone to it. And I'm going to color one of the trees in this color. Now, I'm not going to do them all, but you'll get the idea, and you can see how this would be a really fun card to make. So this one, I'm getting nice smooth color laid down on my tree. And then you could do the other one in a bright yellow and do the one next to it in a brown or a tan and give it an autumn feel. Now, taking that same Copic marker, and you can use, if you have the sketch or the chow, I'll use this one so you can see that it does pretty much the same thing. It still comes to a point, so you can do the same technique. I'm going to draw lines going down my tree here. Can you see those white lines appearing? You see that? I'm going to go over them again to really bring them out. And then I'm going to do them the opposite way. This creates such a fun look. Got this nice kind of checked or plaid look on your trees. And you can do them in all different colors. You can do this to animal stamps. You can do this to flowers. And it creates a really neat pattern, neat texture. Isn't that cute? All done with a Bic marker and a Copic blender pen. If you already have Copic markers or other high-quality artist markers, you can do these same techniques with those. But if you're looking for an inexpensive way to get started, for a small set of markers on the go, or for something fun to share with the kids, you can create vibrant, colorful projects with these Bic markers.